gotten the story of Abraham Lincoln quite right. He was a little bit better than the rest of us. He's probably the smartest person ever in prison. And his learning curve is amazing.
He had his beliefs. And he stuck to the beliefs at a time when it wasn't popular.
And at all of our crisis times, we've needed leaders who were just a little bit better. But Lincoln was really that good.
The essential thing to remember about Abraham Lincoln was that there was nothing in his background that predicted that he was going to be president of the United States. And in fact, if Lincoln had not been elected in 1860, almost no one ever would have heard of him. He was an accomplished lawyer, and he had made a name for himself as an anti-slavery orator in the late 1850s. But even at this election, no one expected great things of Abraham Lincoln.
He was a man who became president at maybe the worst moment our country's history.
At the beginning of the war, at the beginning of his run, Lincoln did not advocate black equality.
Lincoln's principal objective was to save the Union. And then when they ended slavery for too long, he had to both save the Union and deal with slavery through the Emancipation Proclamation.
Here was a man who very reluctantly was sort of taking on the issue of slavery. He really did not want to. If you read any literature, he never really wanted to embrace the slavery issue. It wasn't his issue. And yet he sort of, over a couple of conversations with Frederick Douglass, and really over time, came around to embracing that issue.
By 1864, he's the best commander in the side. He understands the entire strategy of the war on a continental basis. He understands how to use the Navy. His orders to Grant are impeccable. Lincoln is, in the truest sense, the commander-in-chief.
By the end, Lincoln had totally grown to where he said that not only should blacks not be slaves, they should be treated as equal citizens with full enfranchisement, right to vote, right to participate. So Abe Lincoln was a person and president in progress, and the Lincoln that was assassinated was not the Lincoln that was first inaugurated.
Even after his election and his inauguration, there were long moments when Americans could say, what have we gotten ourselves into? Why did we choose this guy? Because he had the ability to rise to the challenge. The mythology of Lincoln all occurs after his election, after his inauguration, and in particular, after his assassination.
His assassination, which unfortunately, I mean, that's what I think has helped him create the martyr that he became.
He becomes Father Abraham. He becomes, for the next two generations, he becomes the personification